So is saving money with Geico.
And their 24/7 access to licensed agents is totally fresh.
Word. Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
You're watching the ACC on ESPN. Taking you to Brooklyn this afternoon for a battle of unbeatens as 5-0 Pitt takes on 4-0 St. Louis, trying to extend outstanding starts to the season. With Rob Kennedy, I'm Jonathan Yardley inside Barclays Center. Rob, St. Louis 4-0 coming off of a win at Seton Hall last weekend. What can we expect from the Billikens?
Well, Travis Ford's team coming in, they were the preseason pick to win the Atlantic 10. So not surprising they're off to the good win against Seton Hall. They're up by 14 in the second half. Hung on to be able to get the first non-conference road win of Travis Ford's tenure at St. Louis.
On the Pitt side, 0-18 in the ACC last year. Big task for Jeff Capel.
Well, Jeff Capel and his staff have done a great job of getting some new young talent in here. When you take over a high major that late in the year, it is really hard to find freshmen that can make an impact on that level. Well, they've got three freshmen in the starting lineup, led by Xavier Johnson, who's off to a terrific start, averaging 16 points over six assists. One of the reasons they're off to the 5-0 start, but Jonathan, a win here on a neutral court, that would validate the 5-0 start. A little bit of light competition to start off with, but certainly they'll take it.
Third year at St. Louis for Travis Ford, the former Kentucky standout. And as Rob mentioned, first non-conference road win under Travis Ford. And there's Jeff Capel on a very experienced bench after 6 years as the associate head coach at Duke, his third head coaching job in the NCAA ranks. 5-0 Pitt, 4-0 St. Louis, squaring off in Brooklyn this afternoon. A young, high-tempo offense in Pitt wearing white this afternoon against an experienced, grinded-out defensive stalwart in St. Louis. They want to play in the 60s, and Pitt would hope to be much higher than that.
Yeah, exactly. Tempo will be a big key for this game. St. Louis led the Atlantic 10 last year in scoring defense at a little over 65 per game. Come into this game holding their opponents to just 61 points per game.
Trey McGowan's too strong, but the rebound stays with Pitt. Odese Toney, one of those freshmen, along with this man, Xavier Johnson.
Well, extra opportunities on the first possession. Two offensive rebounds. That's not like St. Louis. They rebound the basketball well.
Tough shot there, though. That is like St. Louis, forcing a difficult look. Hassan French, the rebound, gave it away, though. McGowan's with the finish.
Well, smart play by McGowan's, the freshman. Just turned back and got involved on the defensive end and turned that turnover into a quick two.
Turnovers have been an issue for St. Louis.
They had 24 in their win against Seton Hall. Not often you turn it over 24 times on the road against a good team and escape with a win.
This is Cartier Gordon, their own freshman. He has a jumper. Shows it off right away.
Absolutely. If you're going to leave him that wide open, going to take advantage. Coming off a career-high 14 in that win against Seton Hall.
Great ball movement and the corner three off from Odese Toney. Neither team exceptional from three-point range, although Pitt has an outstanding shooter off the bench in Jared Wilson frame. Toney the rebound, one of three freshmen, as Rob mentioned, starting for Pitt. All of them grabbed after Jeff Capel took over in April.
Late call, but the correct call by Mike Eads. Here, just this smart play by the freshman. Realizes that there's going to be a little bit of a cross-court pass coming. Just turns back, gets involved. McGowan's comes into the game, averaging double figures. One of five Pitt Panthers that scores it at 10 or more.
Xavier Johnson out of Woodbridge, Virginia, Bishop O'Connell High School.
He played in the D.C. Catholic League.
Got the switch against Gordon and got to the rim. Couldn't convert, but we'll have free throws.
Well, Johnson's gotten off to a great start on the season. As we said, it's really hard a lot of times, Jonathan, when you get a job at the high major level that late to find guys of impact. He had originally committed to Nebraska, but then when Kenyon Hunter, the assistant coach, left to go with Dan Hurley up to UConn, Jeff Capel realizing that all of a sudden he was going to reopen his recruiting, and boy, did they find a good one. He's even been better than I think they realized he was going to be.
Now, St. Louis did not start Tremaine Isabel, their leading scorer, who had been the point guard, a grad transfer from Drexel. So Jordan Goodwin, number zero, running the point for the Billikens early. Here is Goodwin. Offensive foul on the freshman Gordon, and that's early foul trouble two on Cartier Gordon.
And years ago, 4 or 5 years ago, you would never see an offensive foul on a dribble handoff. That's one of the things that the officials have done to clean it up.
Gordon coming off one of his best games against Seton Hall. Replaced early by DJ Foreman. And it's not a deep St. Louis team. They'll only rotate eight right now, missing a couple guys due to injury. Johnson crossing over French, denied at the rim, but Hassan French touched it last before it came out of bounds.
Oh, great crossover by Johnson. He thought he was going to have the open lane, but French recovers with his length to come up with the block shot. Last year he was on the A-10 all-rookie team after setting a St. Louis freshman record with 59 blocks.
And Malik Ellison tied up off the inbound. Possession arrow gives it to St. Louis. 3-2 Pitt early. They're just one of six, but again, all those offensive rebounds giving them chances. Goodwin pressured by Xavier Johnson, and the Pitt freshman called for the foul. Seton Hall gave St. Louis some trouble when they put pressure on either in the backcourt or in the half court. We'll see if Pitt can do likewise today. Here's DJ Foreman, Rutgers transfer. Javon Best, the best shooter for St. Louis. No good that time. Ellison, the captain for Pitt. His first year eligible after transferring from St. John's, so another guy familiar with the area. St. John's, by the way, outstanding, dramatic win last night in overtime here.
Snuck one against VCU. This building's busy here heading into Thanksgiving.
I think it's got five games in about 28 hours. And it's two fouls on another freshman, Xavier Johnson.
Preseason NIT coming up later tonight. I saw Rick Barnes in the Tennessee Vols walking into the building for shoot-around. Said it took us longer yesterday to drive from Kennedy Airport than it did to fly from Knoxville. He said, I'm not sure how you guys deal with that up here in the Northeast all the time.
Should have taken the subway. Speaking of travel issues, St. Louis had their own. They were flying in last Thursday again to play Seton Hall. That's a travel against French. It took them 31 hours to get in on the day the snow hit last Thursday. They actually were rerouted to Pittsburgh, landed, and had to come in the next day.
And ended up practicing at Pitt.
Sadie and Deer off the bench as the backup point for Pitt. And this is Jared Wilson frame. Absolutely red hot from three-point range. Continues here.
Yeah, he's so hot, you can't even jinx him with that. I mean, he comes in and he's instant offense off the bench. He's the first guy in school history to have three consecutive games of 20 or more off the bench.
French can't muscle his way inside. Pitt off and racing. Indeer on a big here. Goes up top for Chukwuka, the center. He'll pull it out. Still 15 to shoot for the Panthers.
Yeah, just good, solid half-court man-to-man defense from St. Louis. Hard to find driving lanes.
That one turns over. Wiley ahead for Goodwin. Able to convert.
It all starts with their defense at the other end. Terrific job, as we said, cutting off driving lanes and making it difficult for Pitt to get open looks. One thing about St. Louis, they're not afraid to play a little ugly. They'll grind it out with the best of them.
Wilson frame, tough drive, and he hits five early for Jared Wilson frame.
And you can see why he scores it at 18 a game. Not just his three-point shooting, but nice drive and the finish.
French always seems a little out of control on the move, and he hasn't been able to convert yet. Trey McGowan's one of those freshmen from South Carolina. French got the body and got the ball. Wiley dumps it off. DJ Foreman converts inside as St. Louis once again gets within two.
Well, that's not a turnover and then transition into an easy two, but it still starts with the defense on the defensive end with the block by French to get them out in transition.
Low percentage shot for Chukwuka. St. Louis will take that defensively every time. Jordan Goodwin brings it up.
Yeah, he's just one of seven from three on the year, so you'll let him take that.
Here's Javon Bess, leading scorer from a year ago, working against McGowan's. No foul called. Foreman, the rebound in traffic, muscling his way up. Finally, Goodwin able to tie the score at eight.
As we said, Billikens aren't worried about style points. They are a tough, gritty team. They don't care how it looks when they score the basketball, but they will continue to fight.
Again, early foul trouble on each side, but it's favored St. Louis so far. Pitt a lot less comfortable without Xavier Johnson running the point. Here's Malik Ellison, the captain. Again, no good.
And French just walling up, making it difficult to score over top.
Goodwin, another rebound. He's got six.
Well, last year, they led the Atlantic 10 in rebounding margin, and in games where they rebounded, they won. In their wins last year, Jonathan, they averaged nearly nine more rebounds than their opponents, and in their losses, they were out-rebounded by one.
Javon Bess with the steal. Wilson Frame fouled him, and St. Louis from the defense starting to make up some ground. Billikens out to a two-point lead, and they've been converting defense and turnovers into offense at the other end.
Well, that's the key to this team. They get out and guard you, make it difficult for you to score, and then they can turn it over and turn it into points.
This Geico ad is intended only for people who grew up in the 80s.
Renting VHS tapes is dope.
So is saving money with Geico.
And their 24/7 access to licensed agents is totally fresh.
Word.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Welcome back to the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. St. Louis out to an early 10-8 lead on Pitt. Both teams unbeaten. With Rob Kennedy, I'm Jonathan Yardley. Rob, one of the things we wanted to find out today, how for real is this young Pitt team? Where has St. Louis maybe exposed them early?
Well, they've done it with their defense. I mean, they've already challenged shots at the rim. They've got a couple of blocks, three steals, and they couldn't get anything going offensively early on, St. Louis could. But then once they turned the basketball over, they were able to convert at the other end.
Jeff Capel brought in three freshmen and two transfers after taking over in April. Again, off to this 5-0 start, but again, all games you would expect to win. This is their biggest test so far at a neutral site against a very good St. Louis team. Sadie Indeer, grad transfer from New Mexico State, whistled for that foul.
And you could hear Jeff Capel from across the way say, "Stop reaching," at a piece of the jersey right there. When you talk about this early season schedule for Pitt, I think scheduling is one of the things that sometimes people don't realize how important it is. Oh, great backdoor cut and feed. But how important scheduling is to building a program. This is a team that lost every game in the calendar year of 2018, had only eight wins last year. So it's important to change the culture. How do you do that? By winning games. They scheduled winnable games at home to start off with smart.
And this was a game that was not on the schedule when Jeff Capel took over. He was able to get it in New York, says he wants to continue the Pitt tradition of playing here. Of course, goes back to the Big East days. Four fouls now against Pitt, none against St. Louis. Wilson Frame lines it up, and he'll take the foul. Javon Bess closing him out, whistled for it.
Well, he's a catch-and-shoot guy. You give him any space on the season, He's shooting 48% from beyond the three-point line. Big improvement from last year when he shot just 32% from three.
Wilson Frame, 83% at the line this year. Demarius Jacobs, by the way, number 15, checked in for St. Louis. Hasn't played in 2 weeks due to injury, so that lengthens their rotation just a bit. Freshman from Chicago. Odis Tony, number 5, moving on to the lane there as Trey McGowan checks in. And Pitt's freshman point guard Xavier Johnson hampered with two early fouls, still on the bench, and maybe for most of the half. So no Tremaine Isabel so far for St. Louis. Jacobs handling the ball here for the Billikens.
Interesting. He was their leading scorer coming in. Grad transfer off to a hot start. Nice drive and finish by Foreman, the natural lefty.
And Deer got to the rim, couldn't finish. Jordan Goodwin wants to run. Best kept it moving. Offensive foul. The freshman Fred Thatch called for the charge. St. Louis, though, still in front, 14-10 Billikens. They've gotten inside early and often, including DJ Foreman strong on the drive.
Make sure the best gift of the season arrives safely, the Cadillac XT5. Current non-GM owners and lessees get this low-mileage lease on this 2019 Cadillac XT5 from around $399 per month.
St. Louis 14, Pitt 10 in a battle of unbeaten so far at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. Plenty to work on for both teams, but St. Louis, again, 4-0. Has to be pleased with the start here. They've gotten inside so successfully, 12 points in the paint to Pitt's 4. DJ Foreman, 4 of those points off the bench.
Well, talking earlier today to associate head coach Van Maken, he said, one of our keys, we've got to play inside out. That's the strength of our team. Here comes the double.
Able to get it away to Terrell Brown. Great play by Endear. Slew showed that blitz a lot against Seton Hall, mostly to defend Miles Powell. Broke it out there and didn't pay off.
And coming out of the timeout, utilizing the half-court trap. They pinned in Deer right where they wanted him, but he was able to make a nice feed over top.
Dad from Senegal, basketball coach in France. Again, Deer played at New Mexico State, but had a year of eligibility remaining, and he was the one who was able to find Terrell Brown. Fouled there and able to convert here.
Well, he picks it up in a wrong space as he backs it up to the midcourt line. But a terrific feed over top, good catch, and an easy finish for Brown.
I misspoke earlier. St. Louis is up to 6 fouls now. That's 2 on Javon Best, their leader really at both ends. And so Pitt will be into the bonus. They're a better free throw shooting team than St. Louis, 74% on the year.
And they get there. They average nearly 20 made free throws per game.
Cartier Gordon with 2 fouls back in. Really a freshman for whom they have high hopes, and a guy from St. Louis. That was a big get for Travis Ford as a recruit.
And played for the St. Louis Eagles, one of the top AAU programs in the country. And Travis Ford's done a good job, he and his staff, of keeping a number of those St. Louis Eagles home.
He's the highest recruit St. Louis has had since 1996. Broke a backboard in September in practice. And Travis Ford has compared him to Jamal Mashburn, of course, a former teammate of Ford. That's heady stuff. He likens his game to Julius Randle, but he got stuffed twice there inside. They go to the floor. Jump ball, says Bill Covington. And that'll go to Pitt. Fred Thatch on the floor, chasing it for St. Louis. Speaking of St. Louis recruits, he said, Travis Ford was at all my games, and he was the only one there. Makes it a good choice to come to SLU. Again, they double in Deer. Gets it away to McGowan's. He's trapped as well. Demarius Jacobs kept it moving, and Gordon was fouled. Trey McGowan's whistled for it. There's that St. Louis defense throwing some different looks at Pitt and stymieing them for the moment.
And certainly keeping that local talent at home, St. Louis produces so many good players. Nice quick hands right there by James to initially start the turnover. But yeah, keeping guys at home so important. As we said, a lot of guys from the St. Louis Eagles, and Gordon played his AAU with Mokan Elite, who had a tremendous run on the AAU circuit.
Third foul on Gordon as Terrell Brown came up with the rebound, the sophomore from Providence.
And Brown was a guy who kind of hung out on the perimeter last year, had 18 three-point shot attempts. He's got none so far this year. That's growing up a little bit. At 6'10", was comfortable hanging out on the perimeter. Now all of a sudden he's bulked up a little bit, not afraid to go mix it up inside.
They had eight players ask for their release last year after Kevin Stallings was fired, and Jeff Capel convinced six of them to stay. Brown, one of those.
Yeah, and he did a terrific job of piecing things together to just get a roster for this season, but they did a lot more than that with those three freshmen who have been in the starting lineup and have showed really good promise. And then getting a couple of transfers to come on in.
So Pitt comes back to tie it 14-all. Thatch brought the elbow up. Jeff Capel wanting a little bit more out of the call. And it's against OD's Tony, not Thatch.
You saw Mike Eads saying he was in the restricted space right there, but that was a shot across the face. I'm surprised they didn't go to the monitor. That very well could have been a flagrant one.
Sixth foul against Pitt, so St. Louis will shoot free throws for the remainder of the half. Panthers already in the bonus. Here's Demarius Jacobs. A couple of ball handlers with Jordan Goodwin in there. And he sinks it. Jordan Goodwin, the hot hand. He's 5 for 5 from the field. He's got 10.
Talk about a quick start.
And Deer breaks down one off the dribble with the left hand and good. Sadi and Deer.
The guys, both teams coming off the bench and having to make an impact.
Son French loves the spin move, and this time it works for him. First points of the game for Hassan French.
Unable to convert the first couple of times.
Played his AAU ball in New York City, although he went to high school in Massachusetts.
He had played for the PSA Cardinals, another one of those elite AAU programs.
Five to shoot for Pittsburgh. Malik Ellison inside, and he drew the foul. Couldn't get the basket, but he can tie the game at the free throw line.
You know, St. Louis does such a good job of closing out to shooters. So you're not going to be able to necessarily, on those kickouts, get good open looks, so you got to put the ball to the floor and try and probe the defense.
Ellison has struggled at the free throw line this year, though. Sinks the first.
Yeah, just 58% on the season coming in.
So Xavier Johnson back in. Sadi and Deer high fives on the bench. There's Johnson getting instructions from the senior Jared Wilson frame. Left that one short. Form in the rebound. It's a 1-point Billikens lead here in the first. Whoa! Fred Thatch, known for his defense. Wiley is the more offensive player. Now Hassan French against Chukwuka. Demarius Jacobs steps into the three, in and out. Chukwuka the rebound. Xavier Johnson wants to push it.
But that's playing inside out. They got a good look.
How about the switch of hands to draw the foul?
Well, up and under. Nice athletic move once he got to the basket. He needed to pull the basketball back, and by doing such, created the contact. He goes up, comes back under, and there's French, who's always challenging shots. The shot blocker swiped down and got a piece of the arm.
Third St. Louis player with two fouls in this first half, and one of them, Cartier Gordon, has three. So again, the Billikens likely go nine deep in their normal rotation with Jacobs healthy. Although they're actually going to go a little bit deeper here. We're going to get Casey Hankton, freshman from Charlotte, checking in for the first time this year. Travis Ford can't afford to let too many of his regulars get into foul trouble.
Well, you knew this was going to be a physical, tough game, the way both these teams defend, especially in the half court.
Pittsburgh's first lead since we were in single digits, 19-18. That's knocked away. Ellison on the move.
Well, that's a good job paying attention in the scouting report on that ball reversal. If you do a good job pressuring up, got a chance to shoot the gap and come up with the steal.
Second layup Pitt has created from backcourt pressure. Thatch against Ellison. Low percentage look for him as well. And Chukwuka the rebound.
Nothing was happening offensively. Just tried to raise up.
Panthers are feeling it now that Johnson is back in the game.
Yeah, what a difference he makes.
Opened up the space there, but Tony couldn't connect.
Yeah, his driving ability not only finds himself shots, but gets open looks for his teammates. He puts a lot of pressure on the defense. We talk about paint touches. A lot of times people think that's all post-ups. Nope, it's dribble drive getting into the paint as well.
Jordan Goodwin and one has a chance to tie the game at the free throw line. Goodwin has been perfect trying to bring St. Louis back as Pitt has been off to the races when they can create turnovers. Malik Ellison with the finish. Pitt by one.
Make sure the best gift of the season arrives safely. The Cadillac XT5. Current non-GM owners and lessees get this low-mileage lease on this 2019 Cadillac XT5 from around $399 per month.
The rules of luxury. Look, but don't touch. Touch, but don't use. Use, but don't enjoy. Enjoy, but don't show it.
If you're going to follow one rule, make sure it's this one. Luxury should be lived in. Now get a special winter bonus at the Infiniti Winter Sales Event. Infiniti, empower the drive.
The Barclays Center Classic in Brooklyn. Round robin tournament, but this is the showcase game. St. Louis and Pitt. They play Troy, North Alabama, and Central Arkansas on campus sites as part of this tournament. Pitt has already beaten the other three. St. Louis is 2-0 against them. And they go head-to-head here. Jordan Goodwin at the line, came up short with a chance to tie the game. It's still Pitt by one. It's the first shot Goodwin has missed today. He's got 12 of St. Louis's 20.
Now St. Louis back into the 2-3 zone. Again, switching up defenses, coming out of the timeout, and off foul shots.
Ellison, the zone buster. Nice moves inside.
You're right, they busted the zone by getting it to the high post against the 2-3. That's the soft spot of the zone. Recognized it right off the bat.
Thought we might see a 2-3 at this end because St. Louis has not been good shooting from the perimeter.
No, they're a bad outside shooting team, just 28% from beyond the three-point line on the season.
Wiley got the rebound on the floor, has it knocked away. Wilson Frame battling for it. Which way is the foul going?
It's going to go against Wilson Frame. His off-arm clearing some space. Right in front of Mike Eads. And that's his second foul, so he'll go to the bench. Good, solid defense. That's the way to wall up at the rim by Ellison. And there's that off-arm by Wilson Frame. He can't believe it, but it was there.
So St. Louis in the bonus. DJ Foreman will shoot 1-1. He's 67% free throw shooter on the year. From Spring Valley, New York, played 2 years at Rutgers under Eddie Jordan, and then transferred when Jordan's tenure in Piscataway ended. 15 starts last year for the Billikens. Xavier Johnson, he would have the plus-minus of the game for Pitt. They've been dangerous when he's on the floor, even though he hasn't been scoring, but he walked there.
A good idea to ball fake against the zone, but he shuffled his feet as he did so.
Jeff Capel taking over in April, and Malik Ellison, comparing it to their previous regime, said it's night and day. The intensity is on another level, and it's not even close. And they've a lot of reasons to be psyched in Oakland about this group. Off to the fast start at 5-0.
And as we said, this would be a big win for them against an undefeated St. Louis team picked to finish atop the Atlantic 10. Would validate that 5-0 start.
And they have some more tests in the non-conference schedule. At Iowa in the ACC Big Ten Challenge on ESPNU next week. At West Virginia in the Backyard Brawl. And then, of course, January, ACC play is a whole other level of challenge.
And as well, the Duquesne, the city matchup game on a neutral court. Good effort right there on the offensive rebound by Thatch, as you said. Known more for his defense, but a talented freshman they expect big things of.
Our sixth tie, 23-all here in the first half. St. Louis still in that zone. Great ball movement. Odese Tony with the and-one opportunity for Pitt.
Well, St. Louis got to do a better job cleaning it up. Malik Ellison has been able to roam at the high post against that 2-3 zone. See, this time he gets it at the high post, faces up. Nice feet along the baseline. Moving without the basketball, the freshman Tony gives himself an opportunity to convert the three-point play.
We've seen Tony camped in that corner and miss a couple of outside shots. This time able to get to the basket, and he gets to the free throw line as well, the freshman from Huntsville, Alabama. He's one who reclassified to join this recruiting class and play right away at Pitt. One of three freshmen in the starting lineup for the Panthers. Out to a three-point lead here.
Oh, you're right, and we talked about how they were able to get Xavier Johnson after he decommitted from Nebraska. They did a great job as well finding a couple of guys who were originally class of 19 guys who were thinking about maybe speeding up the process academically, was head enough to be able to be part of the class of 2018.
Pitt able to trap Foreman, knock it away. It's McGowan's on the move. Terrell Brown fouled going to the basket, and Pitt is starting to gain confidence.
And that's just a bailout defensively. Looked like the big guy may have been able to travel with the basketball, might have been able to turn it over. But it's the defense that starts things off for Pitt. There's the trap on the sideline out of bounds. Do a great job of pinning him against the sideline. But the big guy's out of control right there. You slap down, you bail him out.
I thought Goodwin was in position to take a charge there.
Yeah, just hold your ground. Make him score over top of you. He might have traveled like his puppies were shuffling a bit. Instead, Brown, who's a good foul shooter on the season, coming in at 80%. You send him to the line.
Four Billikens with two or more fouls. So watch the whistles early in the second half when everybody's back in. And watch this stage late with Jacobs and Hankton, who have barely played, both freshmen on the floor. Marius Jacobs, his third game. DJ Foreman up high will take the jumper. Tony, the long reach to grab the rebound. Pitt will play four guards, but they're long. We've seen it in the rebounding. Off Pitt, that'll go to St. Louis. And a timeout taken by Jeff Capel. Beg your pardon, by Travis Ford and St. Louis. 27-23 Pitt. And again, St. Louis was causing trouble for them defensively for much of the half. I still don't know that Pitt has gotten into a rhythm offensively, but they've done enough to take the lead.
Yeah, no team has had much rhythm on the offensive end, and credit that to the tough physical defense played by both these teams.
Pitt 10 of 16 at the free throw line. St. Louis 1 of 3. That tells you a lot.
Yeah, but that's how Pitt plays. They get to the line. We talked about the fact that they score nearly 20 a game from the foul line coming in. But St. Louis is a team that wanted to play inside out, wanted to try to get the ball inside. So surprising that they haven't been able to get to the line a bit more. Looks like Pitt's going to pick up in a half-court trap again coming out of the timeout.
St. Louis got it ahead easily to Wiley. Here's Demarius Jacobs. Again, Wiley, number four, provided the three-point shooting against Seton Hall. This time it's Casey Hankton, his first collegiate points.
Hey, look good stepping out. Stepping right into that three-pointer.
Pitt went so quickly, St. Louis couldn't set up the zone. And right. Malik Ellison got inside.
And right now, Ellison's just putting his head down and getting to the rim.
He had 15 against North Alabama, his high point mark in this season. And at Pitt, he is whistled for a foul there. And that means more free throws. Jeff Capel begs to differ.
All right, and then the official says, oh, he had him behind the back. And Jeff says, all right, I got it. Ellison, once again, trying to shoot the gap as he did earlier in a game, coming up with that steal on the ball reversal. This time had a piece of the Billiken. And so Hankin, after hitting his first points of his career on that three-pointer last time down, gets to add to that.
They don't have a lot of post players, St. Louis, and Hankin is not that, but at 6'7", he provides them some versatility on the wing as they go a little bit deeper into the rotation today. One-point game, Pitt in the lead late first half. Biggest test for the Panthers so far. Again, and Deer trapped, gets it away to McGowan's on the move. No shot, the foul called on the floor, but it'll still be two free throws for McGowan's.
That wasn't a hand check, that was a forecheck on that dribble penetration.
Travis Ford doing a decent slide there to demonstrate what he thought was appropriate defense. Oh, hand got up on the throat.
Yeah, so the officials take a look at it, but I don't think there's anything there. Clearly, I thought there was more contact above the shoulders about 5 minutes ago on that drag through and sweep through that we saw on the other end of the floor. As I said, I think I called this a forecheck, not a hand check. But there's nothing there. That's just a hand check. Got his hand out trying to guard against it.
Both guys got hit in the face.
Yep, and after they look at it, play on.
Mike Eads will come over and let us know.
Mike Eads coming over to explain to us, just a common foul. That's what we thought when we saw it on replay.
Jacobs gets the hand in there, and then McGowan's catches him with a forearm. All of it accidental.
Yep. And I think because of the way that McGowan's reacted to the initial contact with his head coming back, then you just want to make sure that there wasn't the initial contact to the head.
So McGowan's to the free throw line, 74% free throw shooter on the year.
Get off to a quick start to his Pitt career. Had a career-high 17 points in the opening win against Youngstown State and has had three games in double figures.
He was Jeff Capel's first recruit. Hadn't even stepped foot on the campus, but Jeff Capel visited him at prep school, and McGowan said, we just clicked. And again, like Xavier Johnson, like Odese Toney, able to get in here and start right away.
Yeah, and the only thing he hasn't been able to do is convert from the outside. If he can get that three-point shot as part of his offensive repertoire, get a chance to be a good, solid play.
Terrell Brown secured the rebound, moved it quickly before the defense can set up. Ellison driving again.
Boy, he's trying to make things happen, though.
Marius Jacobs knew he had double dribbled there and turns it back over to Pitt.
That's where you got to fake it a little better so the officials can't see it right in front of you.
The young Panthers out to a three-point lead in the first half here in Brooklyn, trying to keep it going.
This Geico ad is intended only for people who grew up in the 80s.
Renting VHS tapes is dope.
So is saving money with Geico.
And their 24/7 access to licensed agents is totally fresh.
Word.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Monday Night Football is in your future.
Titans, Texans, Monday at 8:15 on ESPN.
Pitt and St. Louis squaring off on the undercard this afternoon. NIT season tip-off doubleheader tomorrow. Kansas and Marquette, Tennessee and Louisville. Jeff Capel looking on as his Pitt team, 5-0 on the year, out to a three-point lead. You learned anything new about either squad in the early going here? We've seen that St. Louis defense, and we've seen some of the Pitt youth in ways both good and bad.
Oh, exactly. I think both teams, this is about what they expected in this ball game. Close, hard fought, and a lot more defense than offense.
Tony grabbed the rebound and then drew a foul. It's the second on Jordan Goodwin, who's been most of the St. Louis offense today. Six Billikens now with two fouls in the first half. Tony goes to the free throw line where he's hit once today.
And they'll have 40 attempts from the foul line after these two already. And we've got three and change to play here in the first half. They put a lot of pressure on you by driving the basketball. You know, you think of some teams who get to the line because they're posting up and they've got a lot of interior guys that can body it. For Pitt, it's a lot more dribble drive and penetration, putting some pressure on the defense.
We'll talk more about the ACC at halftime, but is that going to style of play going to translate to the ACC?
Well, certainly, you know, you've got to be able to break defenses down, you know, especially if they're going to pressure you out on the perimeter. But you've also got to be able to make some three-point shots to keep teams at bay, especially in the ACC, which is off to such a great start here.
DJ Foreman with seven and a little 1-2-1-3-1, I should say, here from St. Louis.
We've seen him mix it up.
Now they drop off into the 2-3. Terrell Brown inside. Gets his own rebound. Can't finish, but he draws the foul against Foreman. Billiken bench incredulous.
As well as the cheering section behind the bench.
They called it on Goodwin, which is his third, rather than Foreman, for whom it would have been his first. And the officials warning both teams. Now who's the foul on here? Because this is interesting. Oh, there's Goodwin. Okay.
Yep, and he clearly slapped down. Looked like it got a piece of the arm as well as some of the basketball.
You can see Foreman's reaction. He's saying, I didn't touch him, but it...
He was right.
Yeah,
he didn't.
The foul was on someone else. And that means we're going to go even deeper into the St. Louis rotation. Again, they've only played eight this year. No Tremaine Isabel. We'll try and get you an update on that. They're starting point guard. And so we're going to see the 6'4 Icelandic freshman, Yngvi Gudmundsson.
Despite all that, St. Louis has been able to hang around, trailing by three. If you're Travis Ford, just trying to survive these last 2 minutes and 23 seconds, get to the locker room, try to regroup, get some of those guys with foul trouble back out on the floor.
A lot of points left at the foul line. Pitt 14 for 22, so under 67%.
Nearly another steal opportunity there for Ellison.
Four freshmen on the floor for the Billikens. We did not expect to see that today. We build them as the more experienced group. And there's a turnover, 2-on-1.
Boom.
Oh, Doctor! Sidi and Deer with the hammer.
Oh, Deer and Deer.
Pitt trying to drop the hammer on this young St. Louis group. Hankton with the pull-up. all Panthers right now. But Fred Thatch snuck inside, got position, and did draw a foul there. He'll get to the free throw line.
Oh, St. Louis has had too many turnovers, and these turnovers have led to Pitt getting out on the break. Coming right at you.
How about the cock of the arm? He was going for it all the way, Sadi Ndir.
He knew that was coming. I'm not sure everybody else did.
Anybody else. Most experienced Panther with 71 career games. He's been in the NCAA tournament twice. There's Tremaine Isabel, the leading scorer for St. Louis, 14.5 a game. He had 13 against Seton Hall, but fouled out. And again, we haven't gotten word yet on why he's not playing today,
yeah, guy,
at least so far.
Yep, guy who's been in double figures in all four of their games, the grad transfer from Drexel.
Now, they've been in the New York area, remember, since Friday. So you wonder how everybody handled that experience. But again, no word on why Isabel's not in there. And Deer having himself a first half. He knocks down the triple.
And a nice find and feed by Terrell Brown using his 6'10 size to look over top and find Ndir wide open from beyond the three. Just his second made three on the season.
Largest lead for either team. Goodmundson thought he had the range, but it's a one and done possession. Travis Ford, his hands on his head. Oh, my God, look at Travis Ford. What are you doing?
Not the shot that they needed, but that's what's happening when you've got four freshmen on the floor who haven't played minutes.
I don't know if I've ever seen a coach grimace quite that obviously at a decision one of his players has made.
As we said, all you were trying to do in that last 2.5 minutes is hang on. And the way you do that is run through offense, get good looks, don't turn the basketball over, and hope to convert on some of those open looks.
The longer your possession goes, the less time Pitt has to attack you as you're just trying to get to the second half and get your starters back in.
Exactly. That's one of the hard things for freshmen sometimes. Remember, Jonathan, most of them are stars at the high school level. Goodmundson played for the Icelandic national team all summer, and so guys are used to getting up shots. They're the man. But when you come on in for your first minutes of your collegiate career, you ain't the man. You got to pass the ball, get everybody involved. That's why you saw Travis Ford holding his head saying, oh, my goodness, what the heck are we doing?
I would have loved to see the reaction if he had made it, because I think his head still would have been in his hands, but he might have been smiling. Again, they break the trap, but Foreman able to recover and slap it out of bounds.
That's why you drop to the level of the basketball. Good job coming on the backside, on the weak side of that 1-3-1.
Not the first time, of course, Travis Ford and Jeff Capel have squared off. Bedlam basketball rivalry, OU and Oklahoma State in the Big 12 in their previous jobs. St. Louis gets the turnover. Thatch will slow it down.
There were a few more people in the building in those matchups. I can guarantee you that. There's not a whole lot of bedlam going on now with the small crowd here on the matinee.
4 second differential between game and shot clock. The bedlam is in the execution of Travis Ford's game plan. Foreman putting his body on the line and some English on the ball to score inside.
Well, there's the one senior making a big play.
Ndir came up short. Demarius Jacobs and Trey McGowan's not happy after McGowan's threw the ball off Jacobs, trying to keep possession for Pitt.
And I think we're going to get a double technical heading to the locker room. And remember, that's going to be a personal foul on each of them. If that is indeed the case, I think they were jawing at each other, and I think we're going to see that.
What an interesting first half. St. Louis led for the earlier portion of it, but Pitt rolling along and getting St. Louis in foul trouble. Panthers by 5 at the half.
Duke looks like they're going to have a tremendous season.
Hold up, let me get up in and out.
Somehow this one seems different.
The ACC Big Ten Challenge. Indiana takes on number one Duke Tuesday at 9:30 on ESPN.
Monday Night Football is in your future.
Titans, Texans, Monday at 8:15 on ESPN.
The Barclays Center in Brooklyn this afternoon. Big day of college hoops, big week of college hoops. And right here, it's Pitt out in front of St. Louis, 38-33 at the half with Rob Kennedy. I'm Jonathan Yardley. Of course, you're watching on the ACC Network Extra and the ESPN app. And Rob, if we're talking ACC, you know we're going to start with Duke. It's a foregone conclusion, so let's get it out of the way. What is your take on this Duke team? They are fun to watch.
They are fun to watch. I watched the game last night in Maui. Auburn kept coming back.
Yep.
Bruce Pearl's team was fighting, but the athleticism and the interchangeable parts, and Zion Williamson is just different. I mean, Luke may have been the preseason ACC player of the year, but barring injury, there's no question who's going to be the postseason ACC player of the year. He's going to end up being the national player of the year if he keeps playing the way he is.
It's weird to have this much hype, and we're still in November. But, okay, let's get past Duke. Who do you see as the challengers, the contenders, who have shown something already?
Well, Virginia clearly is the team that's got the experience and the style of play. If anybody's going to beat Duke, and clearly somebody's going to beat Duke. They may lose a couple of games, but they are a team that's going to be hard to deal with. But UVA, Kyle Guy, Ty Jerome, the experience back. Everybody remembers just the one game they lost last year, the UMBC game. They forget all those games that they won throughout the regular season. Their style of play, their defense. Tony Bennett's team, I think, is the team that's got the best chance to challenge for them. But you look throughout the ACC, the start they've had in league play. I mean, they've got 10 teams that are undefeated so far in the season, including these Pitt Panthers who are watching this afternoon.
That was going to be my last point. What is the ceiling for this Pitt team in obviously the most competitive conference you'll find?
Well, certainly it's going to be a lot harder moving forward when they get into ACC play. But they've got young, talented guys that if they can continue to grow, I don't think they're going to go 0-for in the ACC like they did last year.
Pitt 0-18 in ACC play last year, so room to grow indeed for Jeff Capel's team. They are out to a 5-point lead on St. Louis, trying to remain unbeaten, trying to go to 6-0. It's Pitt 38 and St. Louis 33 at the half in Brooklyn.
Von Miller's wanted to build a chicken coop here for months. Facilities said no, of course, but they did let him build a bird cage.
So majestic, aren't they?
They are. I mean, they're not chickens, but they're sure fun to watch.
Don't worry.
I snuck one in.
Wait, where'd he go?
Over there. Chicken farming's a tough business. I don't know how Von does it.
Trip to the Big 12 Championship on the line.
Crossing the Brooklyn Bridge, you'd be hard-pressed to move that fast today. I'm impressed our truck managed to do it. Find your way to Atlantic Avenue and the Barclays Center in Brooklyn. Jonathan Yardley and Rob Kennedy with you. Halftime here with Pitt out to a 38-33 lead on St. Louis, and we turn our attention to the Atlantic 10 Conference. Rob, St. Louis picked by the coaches to finish first. Four straight years, 500 or worse for the Billikens. Why are they the pick to be number one?
Well, that's one of the questions that Travis Ford asked at Media Day a little bit. But the reason is they have four returning starters, all guys who have a lot of potential. Three guys on the second team. But there are a bunch of other teams that can challenge them for sure. St. Joe's as well as Davidson, the next two teams picked in the preseason. Both of them have a number of guys that can score the basketball. Kellen Grady, the preseason player of the year for Davidson. And then Charlie Brown Jr. off to a terrific start, leading the A-10 right now at over 22 points per game for Phil Martelli. St. Joe's has two losses, but they've played a tough schedule early on.
The Atlantic 10 tournament will be right here the next 3 years at the Barclays Center. VCU was here last night.
Uh-huh.
Any dark horses for you in the A-10 this year?
Well, you brought one up right there. VCU, Mike Rhodes' team, you know, they would say maybe he got fouled at the end of the game last night.
There was some contact.
There was some contact there, right? So might have been able to sneak a win here, win the championship against the St. John's team, who certainly had a pro-New York crowd. But Mike Rhodes' team, you know, last year was a step back in his first year. He's got a better roster there together. The way they play, they could be interesting. And then Dayton, right now the Flyers are undefeated. They've got a really good test today down at the Battle for Atlantis against Butler. That'll give you a good test to see where Anthony Grant's team is.
St. Louis, the favorite in the A-10, one of two teams receiving votes in the Associated Press Top 25 poll from the Atlantic 10 Conference. Billikens trying to continue their hot start to the season. Will we see their leading scorer, Tremaine Isabel, in the second half? It remains to be seen. Billikens down five.
Conference championships. To get to MLS Cup,
you gotta take it all the way up. The Audi 2018 MLS Cup Playoffs, Sunday on ESPN and FS1.
So toot toot is kind of like, I should say, toot toot.
That's when somebody's just feeling good about themselves, usually me.
I never had a four-game losing streak in 8 years.
Oh, my God. Talk more about yourself. Toot, toot.
Trying to find that wide receiver. The next, I say, Randy Moss.
That should probably be a toot, toot and some push-ups.
I never get any props.
Ricks.
Toot, toot.
Couple of unbeaten teams so far, St. Louis and Pitt, getting ready to start the second half at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn with Rob Kennedy. I'm Jonathan Yardley. Fun first half, Rob. How did Pitt get the edge that worked out to be a 5-point halftime lead?
Well, they got themselves to the foul line. They may not have converted, but they got there 22 times. They put a lot of pressure on the defense of St. Louis. Three Billikens with three fouls because of the dribble penetration of Pitt.
Highlights from the first half, and we start on the St. Louis side. Jordan Goodwin hit his first six field goals, taking on a bigger role with Tremaine Isabel out.
Oh, he had 12 points in the first half. He, along with Foreman, carrying the scoring load. Combined, they were 10 of 14. Problem was their teammates just 4 of 20 from the floor. They've got to get guys going offensively because they know what they're going to get at the defensive end. On the defensive end for Pitt, well, Malik Ellison, he stepped up, their captain. Played like a captain, making big plays, trying to make things happen early on when they were stuck in the mud. Nice feed. Oh, dear, and dear coming at you. Doing a good job of endearing himself to the Pitt players, fans, and coaches with a good solid first half. He was one of three Pitt Panthers with 7 points. Jeff Capel's team doing what they've done all season long. Sharing the basketball. They've had eight different guys scoring double figures. They have five guys averaging double figures. They spread the wealth in the stat sheet again today.
Travis Ford, a lot to work on for St. Louis in the second half. What kind of adjustments do you think he wants to see?
Well, first adjustment is get his guys on the floor. They played a lot of minutes coming down the stretch with guys they didn't think were going to see time. Hankton, Goodmanson, Jacobs, all playing more minutes than they have all season long. Gordon played just 3 minutes. He had 3 fouls in 3 minutes. Hassan French, who was a rim protector and was doing that early in the first half for Travis Ford's team, he had just 9 minutes because of his foul trouble. So first, get those guys back out on the floor.
There is Hassan French, one of the St. Louis starters coming back, and Tremaine Isabel is returning for St. Louis to start the second half. So he took the first half out. You would expect that some sort of disciplinary situation. Their leading scorer, their point guard, grad transfer, who has played at Mizzou and Drexel, back in for the second half with St. Louis down 5.
Oh, he's got fresh legs.
He might be motivated.
Yeah, it's always interesting when a guy gets benched to see how they respond.
Javon Bess underneath, then St. Louis starts with a backdoor bucket.
Well, that's taking advantage of the defensive pressure on the wing denial. You got to have a counter for it, and that's going backdoor. And Jonathan, as we said, we thought there were double tees going off at the half. Indeed, there are. If you notice, there's one team foul each because those technical fouls took place after the horn sounded. So those personal fouls charged each player, and they are team fouls here to start the second half.
That's 3 on Demarius Jacobs and 2 on Trey McGowans, who does start the second half for Pitt.
You got to go deep into the rule book to figure out that those are team fouls to start the second half.
Well, Goodwin was denied on his attempt at a hammer dunk, but put his own follow in.
You can see his strength when he gets himself going to the hoop.
We're told for St. Louis, Deion Wiley is questionable to return with an injury as Isabel is back on the floor for him.
And that could be a problem for them because Wiley's their one guy that can make three-point shots. Had 3 big threes in that win over Seton Hall. This is a team that really struggles from the outside.
Isabel finds Cartier Gordon, long 2. In and out, Goodwin snuck inside for the rebound. Back tap. Goodwin again, cross court. Isabel, welcome back.
Oh, you can't get a better look than that.
Seventh tie of the game at 40 all, and it only takes St. Louis 2 minutes to make up a 5-point deficit. And Pitt's not wasting any time. Jared Wilson frame and his beard stalking to the scorer's table to check in. And a control shot by Ellison. French starts St. Louis up the floor.
Good extra pass.
That's blocked at the rim. Xavier Johnson on the run for Pitt as it opens up. Numbers up. McGowan's waited and drew the foul even as he was blocked. It's a foul on Javon Bess, his third.
They get Bess from behind. As we said, Isabel had fresh legs, stepped right into that one, has been struggling from beyond the three-point line on this season. But he's the scorer, not only the leading scorer on the season at 14.5 for the Billikens. The last year he averaged nearly 22 a game in his one season from Drexel, after transferring from Mizzou.
He was second in the CAA in points last year.
And rebounded the basketball for a guard, 7.5 boards per game. That led the CAA. It's one of the things about this St. Louis team. They're so good rebounding the basketball because their guards are so good rebounding. Isabel, Bess, Goodwin, all three of them averaged over 7.5 rebounds per game last year.
There's Wilson frame back onto the floor. Pitt's leading scorer and great three-point shooter had 7 points in the first half. The official is going to confer here early in the second half with Pitt out to a 2-point lead. How does Jeff Capel's team respond to an early 7-4 run by St. Louis?
Well, they've just got to worry about what they do. And that's try to get the ball, dribble drive, and get into those driving lanes. Mike Eats over at the monitor, I think again on the foul shot, there may have been some contact above the shoulder. I think they're going to look back and get a chance to see whether or not indeed there was. I just saw a replay on our monitor here, and I think there's a very good chance that Hassan French is going to find himself with a flagrant one.
He was battling with Odis Toney following the free throw.
And you just got to be smart about it. You know, like, you had foul trouble throughout the first half. You go to halftime, it's a little chippy. You get double technical going off. You got to keep your head. You got to play smart. Just got to let plays play on.
Well, here's a look at it. Watch inside the paint, inside the restricted area.
You see the elbow there, but looks like the officials determined that it was not intentional. Must have been a basketball play, and the contact was not above the neck.
It didn't look as bad from the lower angle.
The lower angle, it looked much better. If that was the first angle we saw, I would have said, I'll play on. We saw that high angle, and I thought we were going to get a flagrant one.
Isabel hands for Goodwin, who handled most of the scoring in the first half for St. Louis. Here's Bess inside for French. Thought this might be an area of an advantage for St. Louis. A little bit more size, and it's a tie game.
Well, it was an advantage that time because French able to finish with his right hand.
Xavier Johnson stepping into the three-pointer.
And remember, his minutes were curtailed there a little bit in the first half with his own foul trouble. Played just 6 minutes in that first half, and they missed him.
Cartier Gordon, speaking of guys who were curtailed by foul trouble, and Pitt turns it over. Guys not paying attention. Isabel thought about the early three, works on Wilson frame, gets into the lane. And French pushed off, called for the foul. And again, Travis Ford wearing the I can't believe it expression at the top of your screen.
There's that nice finish, the turnover forced by St. Louis.
five Billikens with three fouls. You can hear the bench yelling Hedge. Wilson Frame steps through it. Ellison into the lane. Cartier Gordon, foul number four. I was looking forward to seeing this guy, and we're not going to see too much of it.
We saw only 3 minutes in the first half. He's going to end up sitting down again because Malik Ellison put so much pressure on the defense. Dribble, drive, penetration. You see his reaction, much like Travis Ford on the last play, but there was contact on that.
But this is one area. Pitt basically starts four guards. They ask Tony at 6'6 and Ellison at 6'6 maybe to guard a four, and we saw St. Louis go inside there. In the ACC, how is that going to play?
Well, they're going to have some size matchup problems for sure, but you can also use that as a mismatch to your advantage if you can take some bigs away from the basketball and beat them off the dribble like we've seen Ellison do here this afternoon.
Pitt's largest lead today is seven. They lead by three at the moment. French was battling in the post, and it's Chukwuka of Pitt called for the foul. Six fouls in the first 4 minutes. Physical afternoon. Pitt on top right now. Much more still to come.
There's no one I'd rather hit the road with.
No one I'd rather have dinner and a movie with.
No one I'd rather lean on.
Being in love is an amazing thing. Being in love with your best friend is everything. The Ever Us two-stone collection. One diamond for your best friend, one for your true love. For the one woman who's both. Ever Us, with new designs exclusively at Kay.
When you need to bring the pep, Maytag will handle the prep. Go get him, Tiger. He's a wildcat.
Maytag, what's inside matters.
Well, Jeff Capel III may be the head coach at Pitt, but Rob, he has some serious experience next to him on the bench.
Yeah, the only team in the country that's got three assistant coaches with head coaching experience. You see Tim O'Toole backing up right there, the former head coach at Fairfield, the associate head coach. Milan Brown has taken a seat just to the left of Jeff Capel, former head coach at Mount St. Mary's and Holy Cross. And then Jason Capel, Jeff's younger, bigger brother, former head coach at Appalachian State. So plenty of guys to turn to when you're looking to try to figure out what your next move might be.
Another foul called underneath. This one goes against Malik Ellison, who is Pitt's leading scorer today with 11 points. Jordan Goodwin with 14 for St. Louis. This game may be decided at the free throw line the way things are going, and that does not bode well for the Billikens. 60% from the free throw line so far this year. That's 323rd out of 353 teams.
Yeah, it's surprising that you could come in 4-0 not being able to convert from the line, but really only one real close game that they played, and that was the Seton Hall game last time out. And a couple of missed foul shots late in the game allowed Seton Hall to cut into that 12-point second-half lead that St. Louis was able to build up.
Xavier Johnson goes inside after they jump the pick and roll, but Brown couldn't handle it.
Yeah, Brown's got to make that catch.
Goodwin pops a long two. Jordan Goodwin had the first St. Louis triple-double ever last year. He's got 16 points, that was a two, and seven rebounds today.
And he almost had three consecutive because the game before it and the game after it, he was just two rebounds short of a triple-double.
He was suspended for the last seven games of last season following a Title IX investigation that you don't want any part of. But St. Louis down a point here. French got away with mishandling that. Gets the ball on the block. Isabel thought about it. Came up way short. His shot reflected his initial indecision.
Yeah, he just doesn't have the confidence right now. As we said, he's been struggling from beyond the three-point line. Just 27% on the season.
Johnson lost his dribble, got it back. And he's got eight despite the early foul trouble.
Yeah, but it's his ability to dribble the basketball and get by guys, sat the defender down.
Speaking of, we see what Tremaine Isabel brings to St. Louis as he got inside and fed Hassan French.
Well, that's the thing. Isabel's not just an outside shooter. He's a guy that can score the basketball by getting paint touches. French doing a good job of sealing the last couple of possessions, getting the basketball in the low post.
Terrell Brown up to two fouls now for Pitt.
It's been a struggle from the foul line on the year for French.
I wasn't going to say it. That's his second made of the year.
Yeah, but even when it goes in, it doesn't look good coming out of there. Hey, he was 1 for 8 from the line coming in. When you see that release, you can see why.
Our ninth tie of the day. 5-0 Pitt, 4-0 St. Louis. Have not been separated by more than 7 points in this one. Tony still can't buy a three-pointer, and the rebound tapped out to Foreman. Goodwin, attack mode, finds Isabel. Oh, what a follow by French. Came flying in to put St. Louis in front.
Well, once St. Louis got some of their guys back on the floor, not saddled with the foul trouble like they were in the first half, the Billikens showing you why they were the preseason favorite in the Atlantic 10. Little French pastry coming at you. Outworking people on the offensive glass. Billikens now up by 2.
When the game's over and you're exhausted from woo-hooing, there'll be greasy platters to grapple with, crusty bowls to do battle with, and filthy forks from friends afraid of finger food. But you can do this. You'll have the power of Maytag on your team. Now get out there and host your heart out. Maytag will see you on the other side.
Maytag, what's inside matters.
This is our workshop. This is our North Star. This is our Wonderland. And this is our season of performance. Hurry into the Acura Season of Performance event going on now.
This holiday, visit your local Tri-Acura dealer for attractive offers.
A little early dismissal on this Thanksgiving Wednesday. Got to get me one of those beanies for the walk to the subway and getting home.
Gonna need it tomorrow. Ooh, it's gonna be cold.
Pitt trying to play in New York City year after year. I think they've only missed 1 year in the last 60 of playing at least one game in New York City. Of course, for so many years, that included the Big East tournament. And Jeff Capel wants to make that a regular part of things. Maybe a bit of a recruiting advantage in the ACC, which, of course, will also play some tournament games here. Xavier Johnson crossing over and scooping.
He pretty much gets wherever he wants off the bounce.
Tremaine Isabel didn't play in the first half. We've not been told why. Leading scorer and the point guard for St. Louis. Here's Jordan Goodwin, who picked up the offensive slack. DJ Foreman left alone, and that's why. Rebound grabbed by Otis Tony. You can hear the cries from the St. Louis bench of shooter. But there's only one.
Go and find Wilson Frame every time he catches the basketball.
Johnson gets it back with 9 to shoot. Into the paint again. That was a high degree of difficulty. French blocked it and got it ahead. Foreman and Bess.
Well, that was a pass that just happened to hit the rim.
It was not seamlessly executed.
No, Isabel was looking to throw over top to Foreman, which was a good idea, just bad execution.
And in January, when they've played together longer, Foreman will be looking for it. The pass will be on the money. And it'll be spectacular.
That pass was on the money.
Tony slipping inside to put Pittsburgh back in front.
But it's Ellison again getting paint touches off the bounce. They've not done a great job of containing the ball handler off the bounce.
Isabel put so much air under that that it messed up the rebounders. Javon Bess, rim around the collar, puts the Billikens back in the lead.
Oh, bad offensive possession ended up just fine.
I don't know that any of that was advisable, but you'll take the results sometimes. We said they don't mind winning ugly. That's off the foot of French. And it will stay with Pitt because it was deflected. Malik Ellison led Pittsburgh in scoring in the first half. He plays provider here. OD's Tony slipping inside, but Slew has the lead here in the second.
Looking for an amazing deal this holiday? Then don't miss the Xfinity Black Friday sale with Wi-Fi from America's best internet provider and Xfinity X1, which lets you watch your favorites, including Netflix. Plus, get $200 back. Click, call, or visit us today.
Now this is Daddy's favorite song.
Alexa, play Dad's playlist. Ooh la la. Ooh la la
la la. Well, it's been such a difficult time for the city of Pittsburgh following the shooting at the Tree of Life Synagogue, and you see the Star of David and Stronger Than Hate on the warm-up shirts of the Pitt Panthers they've been wearing all season. Really nice solidarity to be shown in a terrible situation.
Yeah, we've seen that by a number of the sports teams in Pittsburgh. As a Steeler fan, the jerseys that they had that first Sunday after the shooting, and how the whole city of Pittsburgh was able to rally around their sports teams after a tragic event was special.
Not exactly a seamless transition, but that was a special drive and change of hands by Mr. Xavier Johnson.
And again, he's been able to get wherever he wants. St. Louis, surprisingly, hasn't been able to contain dribble penetration. For a good defensive team, they've gotten beat off the bounce way too many times.
Now, Miles Powell from Seton Hall is a different target to deal with, but they dealt with him so well.
And they doubled him a lot, and we haven't seen them be able to do that at all against Johnson. He's just been too quick off the bounce.
It was a combination of Javon Bess and Fred Thatch who held Miles Powell to 4 of 13 from the field. He had been averaging 27 a game in the win at Seton Hall over in Newark on Saturday. So an extended stay in the tri-state area for Pitt, or I beg your pardon, for St. Louis. Took in a Broadway show this week. They double Wilson frame here. Now Xavier Johnson going inside and scoring once again. He's up to 14.
Well, he shot fake, and because he's a good outside shooter at 41% from beyond the three, you got to get out on him, and then he just beats you at will.
Hassan French at the other end. Each team's shooting has really picked up in the second half.
Oh, French has started to dominate. He's now in double figures, getting his work done inside.
We barely saw the two point guards in the first half. Isabel didn't play. We're assuming it's discipline related. And at the other end, Johnson was limited due to foul trouble. They have been much more influential here in the second half.
There's that ball fake that forces Thatch to come out on him out at the three-point line. And as soon as the defense closes out, Johnson like shot out of a cannon. As we said, played his high school basketball at Bishop O'Connell, one of the top high school programs, and arguably the top high school league in the country, the D.C. Catholic League, over the last 10 years has just been absolutely loaded.
6'3", 190, goes inside, Chibwuku.
Once again, Johnson's ability to get where he wants, and a nice slip right to the rim.
I think it's actually his first assist of the game.
He made it memorable.
Here's Hassan French. He's been heating up.
And because of that, draws a double for a second.
That opens up the three ball. Isabel connects.
Well, that's the danger, especially if you got a guy like Isabel throwing the ball into the low post. Even though his percentage number coming in is just 27%, he shot it well last year from beyond the three-point line. So if you double off him, he can make you pay.
Wilson frame. Usually dead-eye for Pitt, although he was one of six in their win over North Alabama last weekend. St. Louis a chance to go in front. French rolling, soft touch.
Yeah, and he's been able to finish around the rim with either hand.
Pitt has not had an answer for him inside in the second half.
He's got 13, one of four players in the game in double digits, two on each side.
And 11 of those here in the second half where he's had his way inside.
Sadie and Deer into the game for Pitt had a couple of spectacular moments in the first half. He and Johnson sharing the floor. Step back. Yes!
And that was over the outstretched arms of French, who was out there to challenge it.
63-63. 12th tie of the game. Inside for French. Chukwuka on him. With the right hand, too strong, Chukwuka hauls in the rebound.
And Pitt would like to get out and run. They really haven't had many opportunities, only six fast break points on the game.
St. Great. Louis, what a pass.
And a good catch as well by Godwin.
Isabel will reset, plenty of time. Floats it off the window. A lot of contact, no foul. Xavier Johnson pushed up the floor all alone. Takes the foul. And will, this is a familiar refrain, get to the free throw line.
Well, early on, both teams were struggling offensively. Neither could get it going. Well, as of late, we're just going back and forth. Both teams finding some rhythm offensively. Great drag, dribble, nice no-look feed inside by Pitt, and then the answer on the other end as Isabel able to go high off the glass. We've got a good one here in Brooklyn.
Well, you're nobody till somebody loves you. So find yourself somebody to love.
Introducing Levion Links of Love, only at Jared. Explore our entire Levion collection at jared.com. Dare to be devoted.
A little bit of a home away from home for the Pitt Panthers, playing St. Louis in Brooklyn at the Barclays Center. Trailing right now, but Xavier Johnson has been excellent in this second half.
Well, he played only 6 minutes in the first half, but you're right, he's made a big impact. 5 of 6 from the floor. His ability to get by defenders wherever and whenever he wants, even when he looks like he's going to maybe turn the basketball over, it's turned into a good, solid play here in this second half.
Xavier Johnson with 14 points, 3 for 4 free throws, and he drives the young fans crazy in a good way.
Yep, the Oakland Zoo's going to have a lot to cheer about with this young freshman.
He's at the free throw line with a chance to tie the score. And he's been excellent from the line this year, over 85%.
Now the Peterson Center, one of the reasons why it's so hard for opposing teams to win, that Zoo crew absolutely on top of you in the Peterson Center, and they make a big impact. And they've seen 5 consecutive home wins for the Panthers. As we said, an opportunity to beat a good, solid team like St. Louis on a neutral floor would help validate that 5-0 start.
Tied for the 13th time today. Pitt into a zone here. We told you St. Louis should be vulnerable to these.
Yeah, just 28% on the season coming in from beyond the three-point line.
Isabel's out of time. I don't know if he got that off. It does hit the rim, and we'll play through it.
Well, they caught him off guard with the changing defense coming out of the timeout.
Demaryius
Boy,
Jacobs
handles it.
Hand-checking Xavier Johnson, and he forced a miss.
But boy, Johnson's got that ball on a string.
4 men attacking and draws the foul. Brown wasn't able to get his feet set.
That's a perfect description. He was attacking. He just put his head down and was seeking contact. Jeff Capel's team, after living at the foul line in the first half, they've not gotten there here in the second half. It's been the other way around, as St. Louis has found their way to the foul line here in the second half.
Jared
Travis Ford's team just continues to fight, scrap, and claw. 14 offensive rebounds have led to 20 of their 65 points. Make it 66 now.
Yeah, the second chance point's ridiculous. 20-3 for St. Louis at the last timeout. 6.5 to play, 1 point slew lead. And Deer leaves it for Ellison. The captain delivers.
Well, that was just a nicely executed play. Little flare screen forces the defense to close out. And then on dribble penetration, a great find and feed by Ndeer.
Ndeer has some highlight moments, yeah. And that's another late find by Jeff Capel, getting a grad transfer to come in immediately. And he picks one off here. Ndeer off to the races, has help. Maybe could have used it because Isabel came up with the rebound and was fouled.
And credit Hassan French for getting back defensively. Looked like Ndeer was going to have the easy steal. Here's this nice feed, though, by Ndeer. Draws three defenders, and then Ellison coming right at you for the flush.
Six, 380 pounds, Sadie Ndeer is 1 year at Pitt after playing three-plus at New Mexico State. And Lewis breaks the pressure. Foreman to Javon Best, playing with four fouls. Rebound tracked down by French.
Yeah, the 15th offensive rebound for the Billikens. Too many extra opportunities if you're Pitt.
Well, you're playing four guards and you're playing a zone. Rebounding is going to be a challenge for the Panthers. That's going to stay with St. Louis. Lee Cassell making the call. Beg your pardon, that was Bill Covington on the call. No foul, just Billikens' ball.
And this is just great hustle right there by Thatch to keep it alive for another opportunity. Talking earlier today with Tim O'Toole, the associate head coach, that was one of their big keys coming in, was rebounding the basketball, sending five guys to the defensive glass. One of the reasons why they haven't had as many fast break opportunities, but it hasn't worked because the Billikens have been beating them badly on the offensive boards.
Timeout taken with Pitt up one. 5.5 to play here in the second half. We told you about St. Louis getting its first non-conference road win under Travis Ford as you look at the Pitt huddle. Tim O'Toole with the glasses and the hand up in the middle. St. Louis, some big games coming up as well. They'll finish this tournament against Central Arkansas on Saturday. Home against Butler, at Southern Illinois. And a couple games on ESPNU against Oregon State and at Houston. North Carolina Central, Florida State, and Appalachian State to round out the non-conference slate for the Billikens.
There are those three former head coaches again on the bench. Those are all three guys that also recruit, not just guys who are X and O guys. And because of that, their recruiting contacts paid off dividends as soon as Jeff Capel got this job.
St. Louis into the teeth of the zone with French, trying to connect with Bess, and that's out of bounds to Pitt underneath.
Yeah, it was going to end up being their ball one way or the other as the shot clock hit zero.
So Pitt has crept to a one-point lead here. St. Louis has made the Panthers work in this second half. Both teams in the bonus now, so we'll see how much free throw shooting affects the finish. Ellison will be the next to shoot, and he's got two guaranteed. It was a shooting foul.
He does such a good job of moving without the basketball, and many times he's found the open spot right at the high post. Here comes the double, so you got to make yourself available. And if you get the ball into the middle of the floor, you can go attack. And Ellison's done that time and time today. Put the ball down on the floor and go attack the rim.
Good free throw shooting success today, but not for the season. And you saw that as he line drive the first one. There we get Foreman coming out, replaced by Cartier Gordon, the outstanding in terms of athleticism freshman who's been limited today. 7 minutes, four fouls for Gordon, number five for St. Louis. So he's back in there with the four fouls.
Here comes the three-quarter court trap.
Isabel got it away to Thatch, takes a long two. Push off on Wilson, frame, rebounding on the backside of the lane, and Javon Best will shoot free throws.
And the Pitt bench was looking for a travel call as they thought Isabel stepped through that trap.
And Best is not the guy to foul, by the way. St. Louis's most reliable free throw shooter.
85% on the season coming in. And after having a big advantage from the foul line in the first half, when Pitt outscored St. Louis in the first half from the foul line, 14-4, the Billikens have turned it here in the second half. They've outscored Pitt from the line.
They're out to a one-point lead. Xavier Johnson on the move. Playing with Endear here. 10 to shoot. Doubled. Spins out of it. Endear. Yes, sir. Oui, oui, monsieur.
I like that call, but I like the play by Johnson even better. He doesn't play like a freshman. Presence of mind to be able to split the double, find the open man.
Cartier Gordon fumbled it. Able to score and tie the game.
Well, much like we saw Ellison make himself available in the center of the zone defense on the trap, French doing the same thing. If you can get the ball to the center of the floor against any kind of trapping defense, you've got numbers advantage.
Sadi Endear. Look at Gordon stepping outside, but Ellison is open. That rebound is off a couple of hands and hauled in by Bess for St. Louis. Chance for the Billikens to go in front.
They stay in the 2-3 zone.
French blocking foul against Xavier Johnson. Hassan French will go to the free throw line after the break. St. Louis and Pitt, unbeaten on the year, all locked up, just what we wanted, 70-70 with three and change left.
Go.
I switched to Geico and saved hundreds.
Winner.
That's a win, but it's not the only reason I switched. Geico has licensed agents who I can reach 24/7.
Winner, winner.
Now that's a win-win.
So I have this recurring dream. I'm 85 years old in a job where I have to wear a giant hot dog suit.
What? Where's that coming from?
I don't know. I started my 401k early. I diversified. I'm not a big spender.
Oh, sounds like you're doing a lot.
But I still feel like I'm not going to have enough for retirement, like there's something else I should be doing.
With the right conversation, you might find you're doing okay.
So no hot dog suit.
Not unless you want to.
No.
Schedule a complimentary goal planning session today with TD Ameritrade.
Back at Barclays Center. St. Louis 4-0, Pittsburgh 5-0, and they're tied 70-70 with 3 minutes 13 seconds remaining. What a great way to start a busy day and a busy week of basketball. What's going to decide this one down the stretch, Rob?
Well, it could be foul shooting coming down to a close game. We said early in the game it was Pitt that had the advantage, and now you've got French who struggles from the line. You can see why. Doesn't look good when it leaves his hands. That thing's got hang time. You want arc on the ball, but that's too exaggerated.
With Rob Kennedy, I'm Jonathan Yardley. So glad you're checking out this one from the Barclays Center. Xavier Johnson, critical factor, but he's stuffed by French. Those two have been the major actors of this second half.
Absolutely. And the other two keys are, can St. Louis start containing dribble penetration, especially from Johnson? And on the other side, can Pitt clean things up on the defensive backboards, where St. Louis has had their way with extra opportunities and second chance points?
Malik Ellison steps into the three. Javon Best the rebound. Curious to see here if Pitt stays in the zone, because they haven't been that effective at it.
Yeah, even though St. Louis is not a good outside shooting team, Pitt hasn't really been able to come up with stops out of it. But they stay in it.
Goodwin, who put up almost all of his points in the first half, keeps it moving. Isabel blocked by Chukwuka. It'll stay with St. Louis. Four to shoot for the Billikens.
That's a way to just hold your ground. Chukwuka just gets his hands up, doesn't reach over, and because of that, Isabel's got nowhere to go.
Gained 20 pounds of muscle in the offseason. Four to shoot, look for a quick hitter for St. Louis. They go up top for Javon Bess. He's got to create. Got it off, but off the mark. And Wilson Frame, an important rebound for Pitt.
Yeah, and the last two defensive possessions for Pitt, they finished it off with solid rebounds.
Malik Ellison looks to create. Inside, he's blocked by French again, who's had a big game. French to the floor, wants a timeout and gets the timeout. Hassan French, near his hometown, having a heck of a game.
Well, he's known for his shot blocking, one of the reasons why he was on the A-10 all-rookie team last year. That is just great timing to come up with the basketball. And then smart heads-up play to call the timeout as he's going to the floor before he steps on the end line.
13 points, 9 rebounds, and 4 blocks for Hassan French, who's only a sophomore.
And I don't know about you, Jonathan, but I think he may have more than 4 blocks. Many times that's the one stat that gets underreported more than anything. And even if it's only 4 blocks, he is certainly bothered way more shot attempts right than that. You know, he's done a good job of protecting the rim.
So 1:55 to go in a tie game. St. Louis will have it in the backcourt. Pitt looking maybe to pick up with some pressure here.
Yeah, looks like they'll extend the floor. Remember, they've had a good job of attacking this when they've gotten French to the middle against this 2-2-1.
Both teams in the single bonus. You see two timeouts left for Pitt, one for St. Louis. That's 10 seconds. Isabel didn't get it across the line.
You can't be nonchalant with that 10-second call. And remember, it's just off of the shot clock now, so you got to be smart. You got to look up and find that shot clock.
And that possession started with 9 seconds because one ran off when French called the timeout. So now Jeff Capel wants a timeout to set up what's next for Pitt. That'll leave each team with one.
So see it winding down. There's the shot clock in your left corner. And there's the 20-second.
Mike Eads right on it, making the call at midcourt. What are you doing if you're Pitt? Let Xavier Johnson find
100%.
Something.
Yep. And now remember, when he's been in ball screens now here on those high ball screens, St. Louis has been blitzing it. So they've been doubling him, so he's had to kind of drag, back dribble, create some more space. So I don't know if I'd go with the high ball screen. I might try to flatten it out because I don't know that anybody one-on-one has been able to contain Johnson off the dribble.
Wilson Frame, number 4, only has 2 3-point attempts today. He's their best long-range shooter. Ellison gets it in to Xavier Johnson in the backcourt. Tie game in the final 2 minutes in Brooklyn. Sound familiar?
Here comes that high ball screen. See, that brings the extra defender up against Johnson, and the double forces it out of his hands.
Wilson Frame trapped a little bit. Finds Ellison on the elbow. He's blocked down low, but the rebound up and in. Xavier Johnson again.
Well, how about that? St. Louis has owned the offensive backboards and second chance points. Just the 5th second chance point for Pitt, but none better than right there. Well, staying in the 2-3 zone.
Bounce it in for Cartier Gordon. In and out, and the rebound to Wilson Frame.
They got a good look against the zone, not settling for 3-point shots, instead playing to their strength, which is pounding the basketball inside.
St. Louis down 2, needs a stop.
Let's see if it's a high ball screen, he's going to get doubled.
Waves Chukwuka off.
I'd wave him off and just go 1-4 flat.
Isabel poked it away.
Great D.
Gordon to the floor. They're going to tie it up, and the ball stays with Pitt. Xavier Johnson not wanting to relinquish it to another freshman in Gordon.
It's not football. It's not a fumble recovery. Once they blow the whistle, it goes alternate possession. Pitt will keep it. But that's why I don't like bringing the high ball screen. It brings the extra defenders in. Even though that defender doesn't get a hold of it, it's Isabel. He's worrying about, is that double coming? Loses the basketball. Now Pitt will keep possession, but just 5 seconds on the shot clock because it doesn't reset.
Five to shoot. Wilson frame to inbound. Can they get it back to him? Here is Wilson frame. Gordon stepped out on him. Shot clock grinding down. Pitt tried to get a timeout, and they gave it to him with one on the shot clock.
And that's their last timeout. I don't know about that. It'll be difficult to set it up. Obviously, it's got to be a catch and shoot. So they do save the possession.
Give me your best ATO and line it up right here for a quick release.
Well, they do a great job of, again, blitzing it, knowing that Wilson Frame's probably going to get it. Timeout was being called from the bench earlier than when he went to the floor.
Yeah, you saw Xavier Johnson signaling for it, but the call was already coming from Bill Covington from the Pitt bench.
And we saw the, looks like they put the shot clock to 1 second. This is the basket that put Pitt up by two. As we said, it's been St. Louis who's dominated the offensive glass. French with the block shot that just ended up bouncing into the wrong guy's hands as Johnson comes up with it. So not your traditional offensive rebound.
That makes it 72-70, Pittsburgh. 26 seconds on the clock now and one on the shot clock.
Yep, they added 6/10 of the second back onto the game clock, and there'll be 1 second on the shot clock. So now expect Wilson Frame to be coming off of some kind of screen, running right into his shot. We saw him inbound the basketball last time, but not enough time. He's the guy who you would expect. If not him, then maybe Ellison.
Sadie Ndeer in the game as well, number 11. Xavier Johnson, the point guard, to inbound with one to shoot.
Nice execution.
But they missed the rim, and so it is a shot clock violation. 23.7, and St. Louis with the ball. They have one timeout in hand.
As we said, that's the guy that Jeff Capel was looking to try to get the basketball in Wilson Frame's hand.
And because the game clock was at 26, it of course stops at 25 when the shot clock expired, so they set that. Where's St. Louis going? One possession to tie or lead.
Well, one of the things that's hard, it looks like Pitt will stay up in that 2-2-1 and fall back into the 2-3 zone. But I wouldn't settle for outside shots. I'd look to try and pound the basketball back inside. Only problem is if you throw it to French, he's such a poor foul shooter that I'd be worried about that. If I'm into timeout here and I'm Pitt, as we said, they've got three former head coaches over there with Jeff Capel as well. The ball goes into French, I'd hack a shack. I would foul him and put him to the line.
Can't do it too obviously to get called for something beyond the normal, but you're absolutely right. The worst case is he ties it and you get the last shot.
Yeah, and he's 1-for-8 on the season coming in. So far here tonight, he's gone to the foul line a couple of times.
1 out of 2 today.
1 out of 2.
So we're all doing the math.
Yep.
20%.
Still doesn't matter. Yeah, exactly. And they don't look good. The only thing, you got to rebound them because they go up in the air for about... It's like a punter. You got to get the hang time clock going when the ball leaves his hand from the foul line. But again, now, Goodwin's a guy that can dribble, penetrate, get it inside. Best can as well. But as we've said, St. Louis's best offense has been their ability to throw the basketball inside here in the second half.
We got a pretty good look there at what Travis Ford wants to draw.
That's what I want to see. Black and gold, my Steelers. All right, so let's see if Pitt stays in the 2-3 zone or if coming out of the timeout, they switch up and go man.
French is the inbounder.
Yep, looks like they're staying in the 2-3 zone. Jonathan, you and I talked about it coming in. thinking that maybe we'd see a little bit more zone from Pitt because of the lack of outside shooting for St. Louis.
Here it is in the most critical spot of the game. Isabel finds French.
That's where I'd give up the foul. That's why you got three former head coaches on your bench to help you with that. That is scouting, knowing who catches the basketball, and having confidence in your team, especially with so many young guys, that they'd be able to execute that game plan. Good, solid defense, and then as soon as French caught the basketball, you give up the foul.
And it's a 1-1, so the rebound on the first one is key. And, of course, French is one of their rebounders, so it's just Gordon and Goodwin on the blocks for St. Louis. Air ball. Worst case. For St. Louis.
Yeah, because remember, they've got 16 offensive rebounds in the game. Now Travis Ford's team's got to get up in a full court pressure.
No timeouts on either side. Both coaches, you know, are aching to tinker here.
Yeah. And French was a little disappointed, had his head down. You can't worry about that. He's the point person on this pressure defense.
Xavier Johnson is the best free throw shooter. Ellison, the inbounder, is the worst. A foul came before the inbound, correct?
It did, and it's going to send Johnson to the foul line.
They call it on Isabel.
And that's still just the eighth team foul for St. Louis, so it'll be a 1-1 situation here for the young freshman who's played so well here in the second half.
He's an 85% free throw shooter, and playing to that number today, he's 5 out of 6.
So if you're going to foul somebody before the basketball comes in bounds, that's not the guy that you want to be fouled. You saw the execution on the other side for the young Pitt Panther team when they fouled the right guy, Hassan French.
And Deer, 11, was who you wanted to foul, not Johnson, number 1. You saw it, Isabel trying to stay with him at the edge of the paint. It's not in that corner.
Nope, it was off the ball on the other side of the floor.
And again, it was 4.9 when they inbounded it, so they want to see where it occurred. And the clock had not moved yet when the foul occurred, so it should go back to 4.9 would be my interpretation.
Yep, and the correct interpretation. Well, you're trying to fight through the screen, but again, you just got to be aware of who you're guarding.
Again, no timeouts. So with a miss here, or even with a make of, it's a 1-1, so we'd only be worried about it if he misses the first one or misses with a 3-point game on the second. St. Louis can't call timeout. They have to push it.
As we said, he does not play like a freshman. He's got great poise, great presence out there. An opportunity to potentially ice it with this one.
Xavier Johnson puts the nail in the coffin. 4-point game with 4.9 to go. And St. Louis has to go the length of the floor.
And they were both true blue. First one swish, second one right at the back of the rim.
20 for Xavier Johnson for the second straight game.
And now if you're Pitt, you just can't foul.
Javon Best will take the three and hit it with 0.3 to go. Panthers have to get it in here. And a foul called again against Isabel. But with 0.3, there's really not enough time for Pitt to get, or for St. Louis to get this down the floor at the other end. Unless there's an air ball and they can run a set play.
St. Louis fighting throughout the game, as we've seen. Travis Ford's team has done that all season long, and now they're going to have to go to the monitor, make sure that there's not more time to be put back on. If you're Travis Ford, you're fighting for every tenth of the second that you can get here.
And remember, they played the first half without Tremaine Isabel. They played the second without Deion Wiley. Went way deeper into their rotation in that first half than they typically do. And although it looks like St. Louis is going to come up short here, very credible performance again. There's point three on the bucket.
You know, it rattled through the rim, so, you know, I think it was pretty much right on. If it had gone cleanly, it might have been 0.5.
And Deer with 12 points, one of three Panthers in double figures. Trying to add to his totals and salt it away. You missed the second one on purpose?
I always believe, you know what? Take the points. Because if there is a crazy shot, it's going to be a three-quarter court, full-court shot. That's not going to matter because on the rebound, you can't get it off. Solid win on a neutral floor for Pittsburgh. Jeff Capel's team showing you some moxie toughness and some maturity for a young team.
Back and forth battle that saw the lead change hands 12 times. And Pitt pulls it out 75-73 behind the freshman Xavier Johnson, putting up 20 points. Rob, we're going to hear a lot from these teams throughout the year, but it's Pittsburgh that keeps its unbeaten start for our terrific crew here in Brooklyn. For my partner, Rob Kennedy, I'm Jonathan Yardley. Thanks for joining us this afternoon. Pitt gets stretched by St. Louis, but pulls away in the end. Xavier Johnson with 20. Jeff Capel and the Pitt Panthers, a 6-0 start. Happy Thanksgiving to everybody. The Panthers coming home 6-0.